Trapmore gang, we're back with another video, and today we're going to be having a little hip-hop and crime history lesson, because I've been getting a lot of requests recently for me to cover a few classic hip-hop crime cases, and I'll tell you what, the one that seems to get suggested over all the others is the story of C Murder. A lot of people have messaged me over the years asking Trap Lord Ross, please, can you break down the story of why rapper C Murdered a 16-year-old fan? So today, we're gonna have a quick look at some of the details surrounding that case to get a better understanding of what happened to our boy C Murder, or as he should be known, Do Murder, because he apparently did a murder. I suppose he saw it, he did it, and he saw himself doing it, so he'd seen a murder. The story of C Murder. So, C Murder, aka Corey Miller, initially gained fame in the mid-1990s as part of his brother Master P's label, No Limit Records, primarily as a member of the label's supergroup True. So C Murder was the brother of successful rapper and entrepreneur Master P. So C Murder went on to release several solo albums of his own through his brother's label, including 1998's platinum project Life or Death. Look at that cover art. I suppose, in the end, did he get life? He was sentenced to life, so in the end he did get life. Is that an eagle? I don't know whether we've got any sort of bird-watching fans amongst us. My bird knowledge isn't great. I'm certainly not Bird Lol Ross. He's got his legs sort of turned into bone. I suppose more like Grim Reaper vibes. He's got the Nikes. Not sure which Nikes those are, but they're some retro classics. And he's got some good features on there. Master P, called in a favor from his bro. UGK, of course, classic. MIAX, not that, I don't think that's MIA that you would know now. Mr. Cal, shake your ass, watch your shelf. Gambino fan. Family. Moby Dick. Pulling out all the fire features, to be honest. Wow, so Life or Death actually ended up at number 3 on the Billboard 200, which I gotta say, for an album that looks like this, I think that's pretty good. So Life or Death was actually his first album, eventually went on to go platinum. Sure, he had a bit of help from his brother Master P, but C Murder was doing his thing, and he was carving out a pretty legit career for himself in the rap game. In 1999, he released another album, Bossolini, that peaked at number 2 on the Billboard 200, certified gold. I mean, look at that cover art, it's impeccable. Just these classic, like, pen and pixel style covers, you know, what an age of rap music this was. That album was followed up by his next release, Trapped in Crime, peaking at number 9 on the Billboard 200, and this had probably his most favourite song, Down For My... I'm gonna say Down For My Brothers, but you know that ain't what the song is. A track with Snoop Dogg, and you might know this track. This one's a classic. I don't think I'm gonna be able to play much of this for you, if any. It's a chorus that's been reused by Kanye West, and basically he's saying, fuck the mother... because I'm down for my... you know the word. I'm gonna say brothers. Fuck the mother brothers, cause I'm down for my brothers. Fuck the mother brothers, cause I'm down for my brothers. I rap for my brothers, I rap for my brothers. You know what I'm saying? It's a hype track. I mean, you gotta say, this guy was winning, you know? He had multiple Billboard Top 10 album hits, and this is quite the production, this music video. I mean, he's down for his brothers, but it seems like his brothers are definitely down for him when it comes to a music video. I've arranged a few music videos in my time, certainly nothing on this scale. But I'll tell you what, it's hard to get a lot of people to turn up. A lot of people are down to ride for C Murder at this point, by the looks of it. Snoop Dogg cripping hard in the music video from C Murder. Murder to the Super Bowl. It's crazy to see the growth. So it was Kanye's song Blood on the Leaves. He kind of interpolated. I don't know, is that the right word? He did that same little riff that fuck the mother because I'm down for my, I slap for my, I rap for my. You remember the bit. You remember the bit for the song. But anyway, that came from C Murder, okay? So basically, safe to say that C Murder was winning, okay? His career was going well through the late 90s and into the early 2000s. He was doing his thing. He was dropping hits. He was working with people like Snoop Dogg. But to be fair, in 2001, his career was starting to go on a bit of a downswing. He released his album CP3.com, which I gotta say, that's pretty early in the game. I know the dot-com boom would have burst by that point, but you know what I'm saying? This is like rappers naming their albums like Soldier NFT or some shit, you know what I mean? So this one wasn't as successful as C Murder's previous albums. It only peaked at 45 on the Billboard Top 200, but apparently it has sold over 250,000 copies. In fact, C Murder actually made 2 songs for music videos from the album, What You Gonna Do and I'm Not Just, with these actually being C Murder's last music videos that he released before he was arrested, and apparently following his arrest, both BET and MTV stopped playing his videos. So let's have a look at what happened. So apparently on January the 12th, 2002, 16-year-old Stephen Thomas walked into a Harvey nightclub and never came out. So this says that C Murder fired a single shot into the 16-year-old fan's heart after members of the rapper's posse beat up the teenager inside the Platinum Club. So apparently the kid was just a fan of C Murder and the No Limit Records crew, and he'd sneaked into a nightclub that evening, most likely not expecting to be attacked and killed by a rapper that he idolized. So apparently 2 witnesses testified that they had seen the muzzle flash at the end of C Murder's arm, basically pointing him out as the shooter. And so it seems that C Murder was essentially convicted on the basis of those witnesses. witness's testimony and sentenced to life in prison. So apparently C Murder's defense presented 9 witnesses that said they did not see C Murder pull the trigger or participate in the beating. I've got to say, it's quite hard to find like good info about this case. I thought there was more footage or more info from the trial, but you know, it's not very easy to find. So apparently before C Murder was even arrested for this murder, he was already out on bond for attempted murder for apparently shooting a bouncer who wouldn't let him into a nightclub. And I think that incident was caught on camera. So that's C Murder. He don't want to leave. They're saying, you got to get out of here. He's not liking that. Now everybody's getting to running, and look, he pulls the strap and he's firing into there. He's letting it go. Wow. Very, very reckless behavior. So you can imagine he's running around doing stuff like this, and then only less than a year later, you got a 16-year-old fan that gets beaten and murdered by him and his crew, apparently. What's really interesting about this is he was actually convicted in September 2003. However, the judge actually ended up granting a retrial on the basis that prosecutors apparently improperly withheld criminal background information on 3 of their witnesses. So C Murder would actually spend several years on house arrest awaiting this retrial, as well as awaiting charges for that attempted murder case. With him working on albums and novels and all sorts of stuff in the time in between being granted his retrial and the actual trial itself. And it wouldn't be until 2009 that C Murder would actually face the music. In May, pleading no contest to 2 counts of second degree murder, so he'd get 10 years plus credit for time served for those attempted murders, and the retrial for the murder of the 16-year-old would start once again in August 2009, and ultimately a guilty verdict for second degree murder was handed down by the jury, with C Murder being sentenced on August the 14th to mandatory life in prison. And in the years that followed, C Murder would try and appeal this conviction, but unfortunately for him, it was upheld several times. Firstly by the court in 2011, and then eventually by the Supreme Court in 2013.
A key witness came forward recanting his statement. In an affidavit, Kenneth Jordan said Jefferson Parish deputies pressured him to lie by holding an unrelated charge over his head. Jordan said he knew Miller did not shoot and kill a teenager 16 years ago, but he said detectives told him to say otherwise. Now, all these years later, Jordan says he wants to right his wrong, and Miller forgives him.
I want him to know I'm not upset with him, and I'm proud of him, and me and my family, me and my daughters, especially, it's a life-changing moment.
It's interesting because C Murder does still maintain his innocence, and this alleged witness that changed their testimony does seem like the last piece of hope. It's a bit difficult to believe his explanation that witnesses were just trying to put him away for a 15 minutes of fame, but at the same time, he also believes that everybody in the venue should have known who he was and didn't want to identify him at the time. Combine that with the fact that there were accusations of witness tampering during that trial, with a 35-year-old affiliate of C Murder actually being found guilty of tampering with evidence by threatening to use force to influence one or more persons in C Murder's murder case. Even with the suggestion that lying about having committed this crime weighing heavily on his own family and his daughters, that's not enough to get C Murder to admit the alleged murder. And so even with that entire story, the years of legal battles, ultimately with the jury deciding that they did believe that C Murder was guilty of the crime, there is still a lot of people out here fighting for his justice and pushing the idea that he is indeed innocent, including a very unexpected ally, a one Kim Kardashian.
Kim Kardashian teams up with singer Monica to campaign for C Murder's release from prison. And now he feels more hope than ever, writing, 7 months ago, I called Monica and she conferenced in Kim Kardashian. I did not know Moses had been working to reach Kim. After our call, for the first time in 19 years, I slept. You can rest behind these walls, but never do you actually sleep. My case had been stagnant for years, so I published multiple books to help feed my kids and pay lawyers bare minimum. I am a man, so it was no one's responsibility to save me, and no one attempted to. But when you trust God, he will send his angels. This message is to any man or woman fighting the injustices of the system. Don't ever give up, and do as I am. Focus on the blessings, not the betrayals.
I gotta say, once a Kardashian, always a Kardashian. I mean, Kim Kardashian's father made his name getting OJ off of a murder that he didn't commit. And I gotta say, running around trying to get C Murder off, I mean, it's just funny, isn't it? It's just funny what people get up to.
Kim explained in a series of tweets over the weekend that Miller's situation caught her attention because of the 10-2 jury decision and subsequent evidence, including recanted witness testimony. Writing in part, the jury convicted Corey 10-2 and he was sentenced to life in prison. If his trial was today, the jury would have had to be unanimous for him to be convicted. Since his trial, witnesses have recanted, new evidence of his potential innocence has come to light, and there are claims of jurors being pressured into voting to convict.
I mean, sure, Kim, you know, there are some people suggesting that the witnesses were pressured by the police, but there's also a conviction suggesting that witnesses were pressured by the alleged murderer to change testimony to help him. So It's really difficult to decide one way or the other, and I personally do think that decision probably should be left to the courts and the jury.
The R&B star, who previously dated Miller and has publicly expressed her support for him over the years, told Instagram followers that she remains committed to his cause because they are bonded by truth, honesty, and loyalty. Writing in part, "Corey deserves to come home to his girls and be the father they need, be the artist and leader he's always been, as well as spread hope to those who have also experienced this."
I gotta say, the way this statement is worded, he needs to come home and be the father that his daughters need and the artist and leader he's always been, like his art or his songs, which, you know, pretty good, somehow mean that he deserves to be let home and let off of murder. So that is the story of C Murder murdering a 16-year-old fan. That's what the jury say, though several people do disagree. What do you guys think? Do you think that C Murder does deserve to be in jail for murder? Or do you believe the celebrities fighting on his behalf, saying that the jury and the witnesses got the whole thing wrong and that C Murder deserves to be home with his family? Let me know down in the comments, and let me know if you enjoyed this video. I'm thinking of doing more of these kind of like story crime videos that like aren't really quite a main channel video. I'm kind of educating myself, like I knew this story already, but I didn't necessarily know all the details, or I hadn't necessarily like watched through all the available news footage. There wasn't actually that much for this one, but hopefully there'll be more in the next ones. I don't know. Let me know if you want more of this stuff. Hope you enjoyed this video. Shout out to the subs, to the patrons, to the whole gang, man. Appreciate you guys. Till next time, peace.